A deadly boating accident on the 4th of July has roused a heated debate amongst Miami-Dade County's Mayor Carlos Gimenez and the county's fire union. There are concerns from the union about the lack of resources, such as fire boats, that could have been used during the search for the missing boaters. The union claims that cuts to the budget have kept these boats docked since 2011. But Mayor Carlos Gimenez is blaming the union for not cross-utilizing resources with the fire crew at Port Miami. Joining to discuss this, we welcome Omar Blanco, executive board member of the Metro-Dade Firefighters Local 1403. He's also a fire lieutenant for the Miami-Dade Fire Rescue. Welcome. Thank you so much for joining us, Lieutenant.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
It's a clear tragedy. And as much as one can't get beyond that, you have to, when you look at the issue of what could be done to prevent this in the future.
Absolutely.
There are Metro-Dade fire boats that are docked. Mayor Gimenez says that Port Miami officials, fire department officials, should be allowed to use those boats that are there. They exist. But that the union doesn't want, because of contracting issues, doesn't want to work with other departments in order to let Port Miami deal and use those boats to be able to function and do the job better. What is your response?
Well, the response is simple. These boats are paid for with taxpayer money. The community paid to have these boats in service. And we believe that it's a disservice to have them just sitting docked.
But what about the issue of cross-utilization? Work with City of Miami. City of Miami has the largest fire department, in, I believe.
Miami-Dade Fire Rescue is the sixth largest fire department in the United States. The City of Miami Fire Department is another department of which we work very closely with, but we have the sixth largest fire department in the United States.
Okay, so why not work with City of Miami has Port Miami functions, correct?
No, Miami-Dade Fire Rescue.
Miami-Dade Fire Rescue has the Port Miami functions.
Absolutely.
Port Miami officials, Port Miami Fire Department can use the fire boats or no?
Well, what the issue becomes is that we have one fire unit at the Port of Miami that does both fire suppression and does emergency medical services. What ends up happening is that you cannot leave the port unattended to attend to a water rescue operation or a water a yacht fire, as example. We talk about the tragedy of this weekend and the awareness that is brought to the community. You know, I worked with Jack. I worked out at the Port of Miami with Jack from Jack Garcia, and I apologize. Jack Garcia is our retired firefighter who unfortunately lost his son in this tragic event. I sat with Jack the day after the event, and first thing I did is I hugged him. He cried on my shoulder, and I said, "Hey, what can I do for you?" And he said, "Omar, you know, please don't let this happen to another family." Jack Garcia fought for this fireboat program a year ago before leaving, and even after he left, because he understood the emergencies and the incidents that occur out in the water, and understanding that we had to have appropriate fire rescue services out there. We're the busiest port cruise port in the world, in the nation. How can we take the only fire service suppression service out of the port to attend to a fire emergency service? We have to be able to provide.
How many firefighters work for the port?
Four. There are four there a shift, and they run on the fire engine. In comparison to Port Everglades, which is just to the north of us, they're the third busiest cruise line port in the nation, and they've got three units on scene. Listen, the entire area is very susceptible to a catastrophic event. You know, you've got these cargo ships that are coming in that have that we've had fires on before. You know, you have these passenger ships. We're talking about 4 million passengers a year that go through the Port of Miami. We have to be able to provide adequate services to those when they're in need. And we can't do that by having the crews leave and the port unattended, of which we must attend to go address a fire issue.
But is it impossible, and the mayor keeps going back to the issue of cross-utilization, mm-hmm. would it be possible to not only cross-utilize without abandoning the port, and yet at the same time, in order to have a four-man crew for the fire boats, which is an important cost, a significant cost, which isn't there a way where you can both meet together and find a better solution?
Listen, what I'd like to tell you, Helen, is the union has been prepared to work on this since it was taken away. The union cannot put a fireboat in service.
Why do you think it was taken away?
The mayor can.
Why do you think it was taken away?
Listen, last year
he was a firefighter too.
I'll tell you this much: I think the mayor realized that we needed funding to have these services in, and he proposed a millage increase to pay for these services. The night before the budget, if you remember last year, he decided to change his mind, which really put us in a tough situation. In the last 6 to 7 years, we've been dealing with having to cut positions, having to being with a threat of layoffs and pay cuts, and we've had these things happen to us, and we've been willing to be part of the solution because we are members of the community. I live in Miami-Dade County.
How big is your budget?
Our budget right now, it's changed in the last few years, so it's a growing number, and I apologize for not having that figure. But
it's in the hundred of millions?
It's in the hundred of millions, yes, 200 to 300 million.
How much does it cost for a four-man crew to be in the port, to be able to do the fire rescue?
The fire rescue? Well, here, one of our proposed solutions, and something that has been requested from even back in the early 2000s, was there needs to be a rescue unit in the Port of Miami. And we said, hey, let's put a rescue unit in, which we know there's a need for. We see the emergencies, the medical need for it. Let's put a rescue unit out there, as the Port Everglades has. Let's put it out there, and then we can cross map because
we're in budget time, right? Dollars and cents.
Okay.
I know you know the numbers. 2.3 million to be able to have a four-man crew to do the fire rescue. So let's say 2 million roughly, give or take 2 million.
Sure.
How do you suppose that money, how would you like to see, without diminishing further resources for firefighters or having funds shifted, where should that money? That's actually, the mayor can propose, but it's the Miami-Dade County Commission that's got to decide.
Absolutely, absolutely. And here's a prime example. This year, our budget, for the first time, we haven't had to have our guys worried about and gals worried about having to lose their jobs, okay? And we have this budget proposed, and we are having $3.3 million taken out of our budget. That would easily fund a fireboat program. That would easily fund essential services that the community needs. We are the sixth largest fire department. Miami-Dade County is got, you know, we have support on air, we have support on land, and we need support on sea. You know, we have two fireboats that are very capable. We have, the state of Florida has the largest number of registered boats in the United States. Miami-Dade has the largest number in the state of Florida.
There are specific skill sets, I would gather, mm-hmm. that are required for firefighters to be able to do water rescue.
Absolutely.
And transportation.
Yes.
Within how many employees in Miami-Dade Fire Department?
Sworn personnel, I would say about 1,900 to 2,000.
Out of those 2,000, you can't shift a couple, let's say two, mm-hmm. so that you can't shift a few to be able to work the fireboats?
Absolutely. We have crews that are prepared to work.
Within your current number of employees?
Absolutely. We have people that are prepared to work. Now, the issue the mayor might bring is, well, it becomes an overtime. They just want the overtime. Listen, to blame the unions for why the fireboat in service is irresponsible. Why? Because the mayor has the power to put the fireboat in service tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Actually, it's the county commission, really, because they're the ones who really have to.
Well, but listen, if the mayor wanted it, it'd be in.
You think he's that popular?
It's not about being popular; it's about being responsible.
It's got political implications.
Of course, and we talked to the commissioners as well. And Sally Hamm is a big proponent of the fireboat. She is. I can tell you an incident recently where we had lifeguards, okay, on a jet ski go out a mile and a half out on the water to save a diver, okay, to perform CPR on a jet ski. Come on, we have a 50-foot vessel sitting out there with a platform, with the latest technology, with communications that can communicate with the Coast Guard, with every fish and wildlife and that whatnot. We have the capabilities. There were 187 boating accidents in 2013. This is a statistic by the Fish and Wildlife. Mm-hmm. 187 boating accidents, collisions in 2013. There is a need for emergency medical services on the water. There is. It's the largest. If you had a heart attack out on the boat, you know, you're not going to get those services necessarily.
One final point. Sure. There were a number of search and rescue efforts on the 4th of July,
yes,
to help these poor victims and families.
Yes.
You had three major departments overseeing. You had even the Coast Guard, Florida Wildlife Commission, City of Miami.
Right.
It sounds horrible to say, but there's a great likelihood that in the 15 minutes it might have taken for the fire rescue boat, mm-hmm, to go out from Miami-Dade County,
correct,
the results of the search and rescue may not have been so different, right?
Listen, we're unfortunately, you know, we can Monday morning quarterback this all we want, but we know that we're talking about what ifs. What if there was a fire boat? If it was your child in the water lost for over 8 to 10 hours, do you want to be dealing with what ifs, or do you want to deal with what is? What is we have a capable resource paid for, and we should have that out in the water helping look for the victims. The victims that were found the next morning was because of our off-duty guys that went out and helped look because we were concerned. One of our brother firefighters couldn't find his son.
Lieutenant Omar Blanco, thanks so much for
joining
me today.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.